Hi, folks, it's me again, Barry, with Barry's A-Track and Classic Car Radio Repair. And today we're going to be demonstrating a modern conversion on a job sent in by John in Yonkers, New York. This is out of a 75 Chrysler New Yorker Brougham. Now, my service manuals call this a 1978 model, and a recent customer pretty much kind of confirmed that. Not that this couldn't also be a 75 model, but my manuals show it as a 78 model, so we'll just go with that. Don't worry, you're not in trouble if you put the wrong radio in your car, or if your car came with the wrong radio. So I've got it set to AM at the moment. This is a modern conversion. The radio's already AM-FM, so we're not adding FM. We've got the Bluetooth and USB features. We also have my cool master input-output box for connecting external amplifiers, your aux input, your subwoofer. Output from the unit itself that goes through this master I/O box that's requested by the customer at an extra charge, and I believe that's all the bells and whistles. So let's go ahead and turn this thing on. I currently have it set to AM.
We've got it and hand it out to people who were favored by the regime. That's the model.
With regards to the insanity,
and that's one station, and we get maybe two more towards this end of the dial. So we'll just tune those in. See how they're doing today. They won't be strong.
Kennedy and all of our listeners, so please check it out on handy.com.
Okay, and then there's a third AM station. So now we're going to switch to FM, and we're going to see how many stations we can pick up. Okay, just going to tune really slowly across the dial. That's the classical station. For that to come in this area is pretty good.
You just get them to do it.
Celebration Station.
Celebration Station.
And when I was listening, I had
honored you all of God's counsel. Could go to the grave.
Wheel or
okay, that's about 10 so far.
Please remember to vote for Finley Toyota.
Excuse me.
Best auto dealer. Best of Flagstaff. Finley Toyota. Behind the Flagstaff Mall.
Arizona's a dry state, and there is always dust in the air. Drives my sinuses crazy.
Week quick starter pack is just.
Sit back, enjoy the.
So there's about 15 FM stations so far.
Subaru model year savings event
where great Americans buy
for lease for $169 a month.
First events, activities, and
the love ain't
care isn't working directly in patient care.
Okay, well, I think we just set a new record with this one. We picked up I've counted about 32 FM stations with varying degrees of a signal strength, so that's pretty decent. And just in case, you know, from one video to the next on my videos, you know, one radio may pick up a little bit better than the other. It's not the radio, it's local signal conditions. After a conversion, all radios are electronically identical. They all have the same, exact same electronics. They're all going to perform roughly exactly the same. So if one radio is not picking up as many stations as another on one of my videos, it's just because of varying signal conditions in my area. So let's go ahead and you know what? I think the next thing we'll do is we're gonna demonstrate the virtual balance and fader function. Now this radio originally had a front rear fader and a left right balance control. The problem with that, both of these types of controls are prone to early failure. The faders are wire wound, and every time you turn it, it puts a little nick in the wire that's wound. It eventually breaks through that wire, and then the control's no good anymore. That's the case with probably half of all faders that are still in existence. Now your slider type balance controls, there's no support This thing rests directly on top of a carbon resistance element, and all it takes is one good little smack, and that control is ruined also. So I tend not to reuse, even if they are still working, I tend not to reuse the slider type balance controls, and especially the front rear faders, because they're prone to breakdown. And now you can make both of these adjustments with the tone control. So I'm going to demonstrate that right now. First thing we're going to do, we're going to bring our output level meters into the picture so we can make sure that we have all four speakers producing sound. Okay, now we're going to adjust the front rear fader first. We're going to start with our tone control in the center position. And then to activate our front rear fader, we're going to turn this control twice to the right, each time returning it to the original position. And then if I successfully activate it, you'll hear a female voice saying, fader adjust or something like that. So let's try that. Two turns.
Fader adjust.
Okay, fader adjust. And now this tone control is adjusting the front rear speaker balance. We got it all the way front, all the way to the rear. Front, rear. So I'm going to go ahead and you can adjust it as long as you want to. And then once you stop adjusting it, it'll wait about 2 seconds.
Get some help on the farm.
Fader set.
And now the lady says, fader set. That lets you know that this setting has been saved. And now you can return your tone control to the optimum listening position, which for most folks is going to be all the way clockwise. Okay, now we're going to activate our left-right balance control. Same procedure, except we turn our control twice to the left. So let's try that.
Balance adjust.
Okay, balance adjust. And now this tone control is adjusting your left-right balance. All the way left. All the way right. Left. Right. Okay, I'm going to center it. It's pretty well centered. Okay, take my hand off the control. Balance set. Okay, and now we can take our tone control back to where it was before. Okay, let's test the aux input real quick. Make sure that's working. Let's see, here's our master box that the aux jacks are mounted on. And I'm just going to feed a quick test tone into the aux input and make sure that the radio automatically switches to the aux function. So let's just do that. Okay, there's a left side, right side. Okay, now the radio's, now I've removed the aux signal, but the radio's going to hold on to that aux input for 20 seconds just to make sure that you're not constantly switching back and forth between songs or during quiet music passages. It's called a Vox circuit, V-O-X, voice-operated relay. Voice-operated switch, and when there's audio present at the aux jacks, it senses that and it switches over. Now you see the radios come back. So now we can test the USB reader. I've just got in. We don't need these meters anymore, so we'll get rid of that stuff. And I've just got my radio commercial recorded as an MP3 on a little USB stick. I'm just gonna plug that in, and it should start playing by itself.
Classic ride, got a Mustang, buddy, it's a 69, but she ain't sounding so fine. Driving this car, I can't hear the guitar, and all my tapes run slow too. Radio smoking, 8-track deck's broken, what can I do? Send it to 8-track Repair Center, 8-track Repair Center, 8-track Repair Center.com.
Okay, the song's over, and this song I can play in its entirety because I wrote it, I sang it, I played it, I recorded it, I produced it, and I own the copyrights. So YouTube can't do a thing about this one. I'm playing my own copyrighted material. We're going to unplug our stick. Radio should come back. There's our radio. Okay, let's activate the Bluetooth, make sure that activates. I'm just going to, the way to activate it, put it into pairing mode, is to turn our volume control twice to the right. That's the volume control this time, so let's try that.
Bluetooth ready to pair.
Okay, so the unit is now trying to pair. It's sending out a beacon looking for a portable audio device to pair with. Now, as you know, I don't go to all that trouble on the videos. I just make sure it activates, and if it activates, I know that everything works on it. So we'll wait for that After 90 seconds, if there's no pairing, the female voice will come back on saying pairing not completed. While we're waiting for that, we can go ahead and test the 8-track function. Let's see. We've got some bonanza guitars lined up here, if I can just find it. This is like my absolute favorite tape of all time. Not. Okay, we're not finding bonanza guitars at this precise moment, so let's find something else. How about... Here's bonanza guitars. Gotta be sure that we're not picking a popular material for copyright reasons. And I'm just gonna play just short segments of these songs just to demonstrate it. Okay, here's our tape. And there's our tape playing now. Okay, we're fading out. So that means we're either gonna start another song or we're gonna switch tracks automatically depending on whether this is the last song on that track or not. Okay, it's not the last song. All right, we're going to switch tracks a bunch of times.
Pairing not completed.
Okay, as I promised, the lady comes back on and said, hey, it didn't pair. Okay, now we're at a blank spot on the tape, so we're going to wait and see what's after that. Okay, another song, switch tracks again. After you pull the tape out, the radio does come back right away. Here's our radio. Okay, and let's just pop a real quick Temptations excerpt into here so that the customer can check the speed. Just a little bit more familiar material. Make sure our speed's right. Alrighty. Alrighty, that is everything. Test the dial light. See the dial lights coming on and off in response to my command. Alrighty, that is everything tested and ready to go back to the customer. I'm ready to get on to the next job and figure out what's going on with that. Let's see if we can find myself. There's myself. Hi, folks. I'm Barry with Barry's 8-Track and Classic Car Radio Repair, and you've just seen what I can do to even if your radio already had FM, I can just maximize the heck out of its performance. You also get a massive power output increase if your speakers are in a non-grounded configuration, but it can also be wired to your original connectors. At any rate, this is the kit and caboodle, and this is it. And if you have an 8-track player, either for home or for car use, you can reach me at 928-533-9666. Needless to say, I also do conversions on classic car AM radios and AM-FM radios, Bluetooth, USB reader, aux input, multiple output, sub output. On some radios, Delcos, namely, I can even double the number of FM station presets. So keep all that in mind. My website is in the description below. Thank you so much for watching and listening, and we'll see you next time.